Chapter 6, we already finished 5 chapters about meat science. So now we go to technology. Technology is about processing. Process to do processing. Processes which are applied in meat processing. So now we try to understand all the processes. Then it's the next chapter after that about meat products. Today we talk about chilling and freezing and then thawing. When we do freezing and then we do frozen storage, we have frozen product or frozen ingredients. Before we use or before we do further processing, we have to do thawing. Thawing is rã đông, okay? Freezing, you convert liquid water into frozen, into ice. In thawing, you convert ice in back to liquid water. This is the two process, different. Okay, so in this chapter, we have three parts, chilling, freezing, thawing. What is chilling? Chilling, you can call it refrigeration, refrigerating, chilling. Okay. It's to cool down the material to the temperature just above freezing point. Maybe from 0 to 10 degrees C, for example, 7. 7 is already above the on the critical zone, you remember? So you should do 0 to 7 degrees C. Okay, but still above freezing point. So there is no conversion of state of water from liquid into solid. There is another term called super chilling. Then the temperature is in the range of this one, minus 2 to plus 2. And then what is chill storage? Is to hold that material at this low range of temperature during the storage. It's called chilled storage or chilling storage, whatever. It's not important for the term. You understand anyway. Okay, why should we do chilling? Okay, because you lower to below the critical zone of temperature, then you can inhibit growth of microorganism, then you can extend the cell life of the products or ingredients. That is the main objective. Here are the carcasses in the chilling room. Here are the fresh meat products are in the tubing chamber here in a supermarket, for example. And now we go to the second part, freezing. But I go back to ask the question first. Why chilling can extend the cell life of the product? Because chilling can lower the growth of microorganism, but can also reduce the chemical reaction rate, can also reduce the biochemical reaction rate. Not only microbiome, but also chemical, biochemical changes are reduced. And all of them are reduced at a certain rate, means that the cell life will be extended. You have a short cell life when all the changes occur very fast. We are human, we are living, and things are happening. Changes occur in our body, means that we also will have a cell life. If you want to use your body for a longer time, maybe you can freeze your body. After this chapter, you try to freeze that you do not cause the damage to the body. And after 100 years, you can thaw your body and you become alive again. And then you look back to your nephew. You call them grandpa, grandma. Your nephew or your grandson become your grandpa. You never know that. Okay. That's what the hope of people nowadays. Now, freezing. This is a quite big part is important in processing storage of not only meat but all food and food ingredients. So it's worth to learn this chapter. We discuss first the definition, what is freezing, and the theory of freezing, the mechanism behind. And then what are the effects of freezing on food products and food ingredients? It's also important to know. We know this, so we know how to select the right freezing technique, the correct freezing instrument, and so on for our products, for our applications. Okay, and we also discuss frozen store and frozen transport, which is an extension step after the factory. Then equipment is also important. What type of freezing equipments do we have nowadays? What are the main characteristics of each kind of equipment? And then you know them, you can select the right one when you want to invest for your factory, for example. Good, so we go now to definition. Freezing is to what? First step is you convert unfrozen material, usually already chilled. The material already normally chilled before freezing, mean to lower to 5 before frozen normally. You convert the unfrozen material into frozen material, and after that you cool it down further to its storage temperature, minus 18 degrees C, for example. We will see the figure later, but here I try to draw it. For example, the beginning material at 5 degrees C, which is already chilled, and you lower it down and you convert the unfrozen into the frozen, and then you reduce the temperature further to frozen storage. Okay, what is frozen storage? It's to hold the frozen product at an appropriate temperature, usually minus 18, minus 20 degrees C, a long time. Chilled storage and frozen storage, which one can give a longer shelf life for our products? Frozen. Why? Okay, for chilled storage, you lower the rate of microbial growth, you lower the rate of chemical reaction and biochemical reaction. But for frozen storage, what do you do with microbial growth? Stop the growth. They don't grow anymore. In chilled storage, some of them can grow slowly, but in frozen storage, no. Biochemical and chemical reaction still occur or do not occur anymore? If they do not occur anymore, then you have a forever cell life. But actually, you have a cell life, right? You have normally 1 year cell life, frozen product. So means that chemical and biochemical still occur, but fast or slow? Very slow, at very low rate. They still occur at very low rates. That's why you have a long shelf life. Okay. And application of freezing and frozen storage can be for raw meat, can be for fat, can be for finished products for a long shelf life to be sold at frozen conditions. If you want to import meat from Vietnam to other country, what can you do? You have to do freezing to obtain frozen product to transport and to sell. Now we import a lot of frozen meat from America, from Australia, other countries. We import, before we import beef, but nowadays we also import pork, because the pork price in Vietnam this month goes so high. We don't have enough fresh pork, so we have to import frozen pork. And the question comes back. So if you go and you ask your parents, you ask many old lady, they say, okay, don't buy frozen product because there's no more nutrients inside. Is that true? Huh? Your mom will say, okay, don't buy frozen meat product because freezing actually destroy all nutrients. Is that true? No. It's actually frozen storage is the good way is to preserve them for a long time. So sometimes you buy frozen material, it even has better nutrient content than the fresh one. If the fresh is stored 1 week, the changes is already according to, is similar to 1 year frozen storage. For example, the vitamin C in acerola. You know acerola? It's a Vietnamese cherry. This is the king of vitamin C. A lot of vitamin C in this fruit. This is very cheap because it's popular, but actually you should eat this time to time. It gives you a lot of vitamin C. Means improve your immunity. Means you don't get flu and so on, cold or so on easily. But then when you store at room temperature, after 3 days, you lose 70% of vitamin C. When you put in a fridge in chilling condition, after 1 week, maybe you lose 30% of vitamin C. But you put in frozen condition, after 1 year, you lose maybe 20% of vitamin C. So which one is the best to preserve? Frozen storage. Okay, so fresh. Of course, fresh ingredient contain the highest amount of nutrient, but it should be fresh. Fresh means you just harvest around your house, and then you eat within several hours, and it's fresh. But here, they do harvesting, and they have to store it for a while, and the transportation, and they sell it for several days at normal room temperature. It's not fresh anymore. Means it's already several days. You lose quite a lot nutrient. When you talk about nutrient, then you talk normally about vitamin, about polyphenol, the antioxidant, the good component, which are sensitive to be lost. But for protein, for fat, and for carbohydrate, they will not degrade anyway. They will not be to lose fast like vitamin. Chapter 6, we are discussing about chilling, freezing, and thawing, right? So what is the difference between chilling and freezing? Just a short review. Okay. Not only in the temperature, but also in the state of material, in the state of water. In chilling, there is no freezing of water. But in freezing, water is converted from liquid into solid. Or at least part of it is converted into solid. And then thawing is an opposite process compared to freezing, where the frozen state is converted into normal state, liquid state again, before further processing or cooking, for example. We already discussed the chilling, and now we are now at the freezing. So in this part, freezing, we do a short definition already. We did already.